Fran was having a black coffee and heavy metal kind of an afternoon. This followed what had been a black coffee and Radio 4 kind of a morning. Just how he liked it, when he had bits of design to finish off. Work smattered with social networking, comments to and fro. The bean of choice this week was Sumatran and Fulsom. He gulped it down, holding the cup in his left hand, eyes fixed on the screen, right hand fidgeting on the pad. By noon, Fran was halfway through his third pot and still pouring the bold, black liquid down his neck. Radio 4 proved insufficient for his racing heart, and he filled the room with Sabbath. Left knee vibration, dry mouth, and shits abounded. With increasing frequency, he would smoke cigarettes to soften the edge of the caffeine. This meant stepping out onto the balcony of the white, open-plan apartment, passing through the modern kitchen space on the way. There, the pot, like an altar, begged homage. Cup refilled, cigarette smoked, cycle repeated. By 1:30, the cigarettes were so numerous he had moved the laptop to the kitchen counter. The pissing so regular he'd stopped flushing the toilet, not wanting to waste water. By 3, he'd lost count of pots. Perhaps 6. It started with a sneeze. Dark speckles covered the display. Automatically, a jittery hand moved up to his nose. It came back, coated in the dark, syrupy flow, already quickening, filling his skull with spicy, herbal notes and earthy aromas. He felt a warm and accelerating outpouring within his trousers. His ears began to gush and spurt onto the collar of his expensive cotton shirt. The simmering nausea, which had been with him since pot number 2, began to boil up in his stomach. He almost made it to the sink, spraying the pristine white worktop with a tide of mahogany along the way. The pressure in his ears was becoming unbearable as the hot, dark liquid jetted out from either side of his head. He gagged and fought to catch a breath through the torrent of Indonesian black gold from mouth and nose. The sink steamed and frothed as it brimmed. Fran gripped the counter with pallid fingers, certain his head was going to explode as the hot, sultry stuff propelled from every orifice. Fran came around, flat on his back, on the kitchen floor. Above him, he noticed the coffee pot was empty.